Friday Night Football Frenzy is presented by Bay State Savings Bank, Herb Chambers Toyota of Auburn, and UMass Memorial Healthcare.
Coming up next on the Friday Night Football Frenzy, it's a big one at the mountaintop as the St. John's Pioneers visit Wachusett. Swickle leaders square off as the Uxbridge Spartans visit the Leicester Wolverines. For the first time in 70 years, the St. Peter-Marian Guardians battle the undefeated Northbridge Rams. And Division 4 seeds are on the line as Doherty visits the reservation to face Tantasqua. Here we go. The Frenzy starts right now.
It's an opportunity. It's our opportunity to beat them on our field tonight. And that's what we're going to do.
1, 2, 3,
let's go!
Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Friday Night Football Frenzy. Andy Lacombe, little brother Tim McCone with me here, sitting in for Kevin Shea tonight. And, Coner, we had cold weather tonight, so the hitting weather was out, but we have a legit 5-6 major league showdowns for you on the Frenzy tonight. Big-time contests, and we start with you up in the mountaintop.
I have some big-time matchups. Perfect night to be called up to the varsity. I'm ready to go.
There you go.
St. John's taking on Wachusett. Just a few people out for this game, by the way. We pick it up. Second half, Wachusett down 7-6 when the QB, Ben Lucia, rolls out, keeps it himself, and he's going to get all the way down to the 2-yard line. Next play. It's Lucia again, and he's going to keep it himself. Nope, scratch that. He's going to hand it off. Running back gets in for the touchdown, 12-6, Wachusett. St. John's now. Keep an eye on the top of your screen. You're gonna see the defender jump off sides. The quarterback there, Tim Cassidy, knows it, and he takes a shot deep, and he finds Sam Goodhue, breaks a tackle, and he's gone. We're all tied up at 12.
Smart football.
Wachusett then would take the lead. We missed it though, the fans excited nonetheless.
They were fired up, yeah.
Don't text Kevin Shea and shoot. That's the moral of the story.
Hey, then Tim Cassidy
ties it there with the QB sneak. Less than 2 minutes to go. Wachusett driving, but then Nkunju McBride with the pick and St. John's in business. Under a minute to go in this game.
Hey, Connor, what's the score? Hey,
that's exactly what it was. Cassidy drops back. Goes deep again. Cam Lucy makes the catch over the middle for the big game. That sets up roughly a 33-yard field goal for the junior Nick Barton. It's up and it's good. St. John's, your winner, 23-20 in an instant classic.
Wow. All right, this is undefeated Northbridge hosting SPM under the lights of LaSalle Field. First quarter, Kobe Schofer hitting Chandler Brooks, a big gainer for Brooksy. Ripped out of bounds after a big first down. A couple plays later, Schofer rolling and looking and finding Brooks back to the end zone for the touchdown. 7-0 Northbridge, and the young fans happy about it. That guy wanted to be on TV right from the jump tonight. Next Northbridge possession, Falconer, you know what I'm talking about. Schofer hitting wide open Jake Wood, and Woody's gone to the house. 13-0 Rams. Next drive, and it's not a replay. Schofer airing it out. Wood high pointing the football, hands play, and there goes Wood. 20-0, Northbridge. Are you kidding? Northbridge. Defense playing big as well, as they do. Chandler Brooks, look at this, Conan. One-handed pick. Oh, great hands, team. Northbridge, by the way, wins 46-0 tonight. It's their sixth straight shutout. You can't question the Rams. Their fans loved it.
All right, we got a battle of the unbeatens, Nashoba Chieftains at Leominster. Nashoba 14-7 at the half. Pick it up. Third quarter, Leominster strikes. Noah Gray to Anthony Dandini on fourth down. We're tied up at 14. Back comes Nashoba, though. Robbie Atwood, nice play action fake. Hits Tony Cannon in stride. 45-yard touchdown, Chieftains up 21-14. Here come the Blue Devils, though. There they are. Gray to Ethan Hill. Little screen pass. Hill finally brought down at the Nashoba 13. Fourth and four. Gray rolls out. Finds Keith Jackson for the score, and we're all tied up at 21. Fourth quarter now. Nashoba on a big-time drive, capped by Atwood on the QB sneak. Nashoba stops Leominster's two-point conversion. Chieftains are going to win it. 28-27 is your final.
There'll be a new number one next week. Warriors are out cheering on their team on the reservation, hosting Doherty. 14-13, Tantasqua, Jordan Chiquette rolling and hitting the big guy, J.J. Holland. Woo, going up to get it, 21-13, Warriors. Later in the second, Doherty's quarterback, Nick David, hitting Tariq Massenburg. Massenburg down to the 18-yard line. Next play, going to the end zone. And it is broken up by Jordan Chiquette on defense. There's the fourth down now coming up. Fourth down, Doherty's going for it. Looking again into the end zone, it is incomplete. The Warriors hold on defense. Third quarter we go, Doherty. Manny Brown putting on the moves, and then Manny with the speed, 57 yards for the touchdown. Cut the lead to 21-19. Tantasqua winning at home tonight, 28-19, a big win for the Warriors.
All right, the future of West Boylston football, watching their team take on Maynard. First quarter, Maynard down 6-0 when Cal Hose finds Eric Kelly over the middle. Nice catch there for the first down, but the drive would stall. Second quarter, West Boylston to the ground game. And it's Cole McCubry.
Yeah, it is.
Breaks a tackle. And he's going to pick up the first down. You're going to sense a theme here in these highlights. Now it's McCubry again.
He touches the ball a lot.
That's a touchdown for McCubry. And he wasn't done, believe it or not. McCubry now.
I do believe.
Going to get the ball again. Makes a cut. Stays on his feet. Takes it all the way down to the two. They line up again. And who else but McCubry? Breaks another tackle, gets in for the touchdown. West Boylston, your winner, 26-6 tonight.
Tooch all fired up about the line play for WB tonight. Uxbridge and Leicester, second half, 14-6. Wolverines going to the air, and Oliver Sawyer picks it off. And Sawyer taking it back. Next play, Josh Callinan. Falling in the pass, he goes in for the touchdown. Failed two-point conversion, 14-12. Uxbridge trailing, then in the fourth quarter. Sawyer for the touchdown. Uxie wins, 18-14, knocking off Leicester tonight.
All right, Shepherd Hill looking for win number two on the road at Fitchburg. First quarter, here come the Rams. Jake Zablocki on the sweep, led by Alec Lindstrom, gets to the sideline, and he'll finally be knocked out of bounds at the 4-yard line.
Zabs knows.
Next play. Sarcody rumbles in for the score, 7-0 Shepherd Hill.
David is a stud.
They're back, baby. He can play football. Hill on the defensive side. Pass picked off by Mick Sullivan, and the Rams are going to have great field position.
They're fired up.
Here they come.
They're all fired up. Big one, though, tonight.
They're going to win it 41-26 is your final.
All right. So there you go. Some big ones and a lot of showdowns that we feature here in the A block. And I want to talk quickly about Northbridge. Just putting a statement together. I thought it'd be a real tall ask for the defense to come up with another shutout against a talented team with Baldino and Malm and P.J. Barry and all the weapons they have over there at St. Peter-Marian, and they did it again. Mike Quinn was outstanding in the middle of the football field, and Kobe Schofer, they challenged him to throw it deep, and his athletes made plays. Northbridge is legit, no question.
I saw a great one today.
Yeah, you did.
Instant classic, St. John's and Wachusett. The rivalry speaks for itself. And you hear Bill Belichick talk about it all the time. Offense, defense, special teams. Special teams coming up huge tonight for St. John's as Nick Barton knocks in the game winner. There aren't a lot of teams in the NFL that would feel comfortable sending their kicker out in that situation. Yeah. St. John's does it, and it pays off for a huge win.
Hasn't been a good year for kickers, but it is in high school. We're back with a big one, Algonquin and Holy Name, right after the break. Stay with us.
Discover the Toyota of your dreams today at Herb Chambers Toyota of Auburn. Find the service you'd expect from a 2014 Toyota President's Award-winning dealership. We have a huge selection of new Toyotas and pre-owned vehicles for you to choose from. Shop with confidence at the Auburn Chamber of Commerce's best new and used automotive dealership. We've got the perfect Toyota waiting for you. Visit us at Herb Chambers Toyota of Auburn today, right on Route 20, or online at herbchamberstoyotaofauburn.com.
What's the rush, Coach?
It's Friday. I need to make a deposit before the bank closes.
Haven't you heard? Bay State Savings Bank has a brand new virtual branch. You can deposit that check right from your phone. You can also open accounts and complete other transactions right from your mobile device or home computer.
So now I can do my banking from anywhere.
It's banking at your convenience so you have more time to do the things you enjoy, like
watch the Friday night football frenzy.
Bay State Savings Bank. We take banking personally.
Member FDIC. DIF Equal Housing Lender.
When it comes to healthcare, one phone number is all you need to remember. 855-UMASS-MD. 855-UMASS-MD connects you to our network of more than 1,600 great doctors with expertise in every specialty for adults, kids, and babies. More doctors, more expertise, more locations. Wherever you are, we are there. UMass Memorial Healthcare. 855-UMASS-MD.
Welcome to the Compass Tavern. At the Compass, we offer a delicious menu featuring the best American style and New England dishes made from scratch in our kitchen. Come bring the family and enjoy your favorite sporting events on one of our 16 TV screens. Mention Friday Night Football Frenzy and you get 50% off our sumptuous appetizers. Or come in for our exceptional Sunday brunch. Whether it's lunch, dinner, or special celebrations, the Compass Tavern is the place to go. Friday Night Football Frenzy is brought to you by Unibet, Holy Cross Athletics, the law offices of Joseph J. Curricula, the Compass Tavern, St. John's High School of Shrewsbury, Proterra Nissan of Auburn, Poochie's, Milford Federal Savings Bank, Enchanted Fireside, and Carl's Oxford Diner.
All right, welcome back. A lot of big matchups tonight and a lot of teams trying to find out just how good they are. And a big one out in Northborough at Dick Walsh Field tonight, between Algonquin and Holy Name. 2-3 win teams looking for number four tonight. Algonquin fans are all fired up to see Cam Jandro out there tonight shooting these highlights. Third quarter, 7-6 Algonquin. Max Sarasoli breaking off a long touchdown run. And the Rock Chalk Teahawk is up 13-6. Teahawks then, Billy Palomeros. Next possession, grinding out the extra yardage for the first down. So this is a long drive. It goes into the fourth quarter. In the fourth quarter, Teahawks, Ryan Berry hits Colin Robinson inside the 10. It would set up a touchdown, and Algonquin would lead 20-6. So here we go, fourth quarter. Holy Name offense going for it on fourth down. Kevin Mensah picking it up for the Naps. That would set up Elliot Ortiz. Ortiz cutting it back, finds the big guys, and he's going to end up being pushed into the end zone. 20-12, Naps go for two. Kevin Mensah converting behind big Liam Perry. 20-14 at that point. Naps will get the ball back late, last chance. Teahawks defense rising. Kyle Menezes with the interception. Algonquin wins 20-14.
All right, Auburn at Bartlett. Auburn cheerleaders are pumped up for this one. Auburn ball, third quarter. QB Steve Saucier fakes it. Keeps it himself, gets in for the touchdown. Two-point conversion. It's good. TJ Medlin gets in, 8-0 Auburn. We go to the coaching staff. Mike Kelly, my favorite coach in Central Mass. He's got Bancroft in his blood. That's good. Whew. All right, Auburn ball again. Saucier throws to Avery Lemansky. First down, Auburn.
Michael Kelly, most filmed coach on the Frenzy in the last 2 years.
And with good reason. Yep. A couple plays later. leads to a touchdown. That's Ben Jeté getting in for the score for Auburn. Two-point conversion.
I like that you Frenched up Jetty. I like it.
It's the Bancroft education by TJ Medlin. Again, gets in. Final score, 16-0, Auburn. Groton Dunstable and Hudson, senior night for the Crusaders. First quarter, Groton Dunstable's J.C. Thorburn gets the sack. Then, Groton Dunstable, Michael Tomorrow, handoff to Shane Dawson. Gets in for the touchdown, 7-0, Groton Dunstable.
Those are quite the porters.
Student section fired up. We jump to the second quarter. Hudson's Armel Conyers looking downfield. And he connects with Chris LaFlamme. Then.
He's still going.
Conyers.
He's running now, Conner. He's going
We're
in.
We're trying to figure this out. Gets in for the touchdown. 7-7 all Hudson. Then Groton Dunstable. Shane Dawson gets the handoff. Pushes through the D to the 1 yard line. Groton Dunstable's Michael Tomorrow. Handoff to Logan Higgins. In for the score. 15-7, Groton Dunstable. They go on to win this one. 25-14 is your final.
Boldy would have never done that to you. Grafton hosting David Prouty. Second quarter, 14-0 Indians. Matt O'Brien not being a nice host. OB just coming in with a big time hit. He is a football player. Then it is O'Brien. Late second quarter in the Wildcat, chewing up yardage. This is his third straight run. This one gets a first and goal for Grafton. A couple plays later. It is O'Brien following his blocks into the end zone. 21-0 Indians at the break. Well, just before the break, rather. It's Darryl Beer Jr. Look at DJ Beer go. Beek is a gamer, ladies and gentlemen. Quick, big answer there, but time would run out on the Panthers. So it was 21-0 going into that. Six-time state champs, the Grafton cheerleaders, just killing it at halftime. Crushing it. Third quarter, Grafton's Ifatu Melifano just cruising into the end zone. 25-yard touchdown. Grafton wins 34-0.
All right.
Nope. Yep. Here we go. You're getting fired up for this
I'm
one.
I'm just too excited. I'm ready to
Marlboro
jump in.
And North Middlesex from Kelleher Field. Owen Capadonna. Mr. Capadonna. Mr. Owen Capadonna. Breaking free. Big time gainer here. Late penalty would drag it back a few yards. But it's a big play. And it sets up this Panther touchdown. Number 11 in your program, number one in his parents' hearts. We're not sure who he is, but he's in. 7-0, Marlboro. Number change on Mahoney's staff over there. North Middlesex, first play from scrimmage. Anton Dotson breaks 1, 2, 3, 4 tackles, cuts it back, and he's going to go 80 yards to the land of six. 7-6, Marlboro. Panthers, though, would respond. B. Rabbit, Brian Short. Hitting Ryan Meckler, 11-yard touchdown, 14-6 Marlboro. Second quarter, the Panther defense getting a stop in the red zone. Sam Diaz breaking up a pass. Marlboro wins 42-13.
All right, now I'm ready. Southbridge taking on Millbury. Pick it up in the first quarter. Ball's on the 19-yard line. Southbridge's quarterback, Anthony Santos, pitches the ball to Giovanni Ortiz, and he gets in for the touchdown. Extra point was no good, 6-0 Southbridge. On the kickoff return, Millbury's John Ruman. He's going to get it, and he's gone. He's going to go all the way for the touchdown. Extra point was good. Millbury on top, 7-6. We're still in the first quarter. Southbridge with the ball. Santos to Brendan Casello. He runs in for another touchdown. Extra point, no good, 12-7 Southbridge. Second quarter, Millbury coming back. John Ruman throws to Antonio Vertum. And look at the speed there, breaks away.
Antonio can play.
He's a good player. Extra point, good, 20-14. Southbridge still on top. Still second quarter, Millbury again. The handoff to Nicholas Lirio, breaks a tackle. Gets in for the touchdown. Final score, Southbridge, 28-21. Oxford taking on Boston Latin Academy.
What?
First quarter.
Boston
I just read
Latin?
It. Quarterback John Tien completes a nice pass to Ian Coakley with a nice pickup. Then Tien hands the ball off to Quinton DeFeo. And Quinton DeFeo is in for the touchdown. Two-point conversion good. 8-0 Dragons. Still in the first quarter, more of the same. Tien hands the ball off to Sean Washington. And no one's going to stop him until he's knocked out of bounds by Nico Murray of the Pirates. That's where they get you. Then,
they get you
here
there.
We go again. Tien on a rollout, hands the ball off to Coakley for another touchdown. Two-point conversion, no good. 14-0 Dragons. Dragons continue to pile on the points. By the second quarter, they're up 20-0. But the trap.
I got to tell you, Connor, it's going to get weird.
It's going to get Dragons. Real weird. We've got...
Two dragons
all over the place. An interception there by Patrick Fitzgerald. Runs out of the ball. Final score, 48-14 Dragons.
That's marvelous.
Patrick Flynn getting the lawyer, getting the Boston Latin team in. This is Quaybog and Assabet Valley. First quarter, John Hogan for the Cougars. Upstairs to Hartley Richards. And Harley dragging it in 31 yards inside the 20. He's fired up. Later in the drive, Cougars punch it into the end zone. Junior Fabian, the receiver on that one, 6-0, Quaybog. Same score, Assabet driving, 18 yards, the chunk of yards being ripped off here by Gabriel Souza. Souza getting it done. Later in the drive, Jesus Pizarro exploring out there in Warren.
I like it, keep that ball high and tight.
And Wes Brookfield, 27 yards for the touchdown, 7-6 Assabet Valley. This one ends in a 50-30 Assabet win. Big time scoring out there. This is Groton in Middlesex. This is the ISL under the sunny skies this afternoon. Prep football. Groton's John Beatty with a handoff. Great blocking up front. The Middlebury bound senior is gone. Zebras have a 7-0 lead. Then, after Middlesex cut the lead to 1, it's Beatty again. Putting on some moves. And then it's Beatty taking off. His second touchdown of the first quarter, 14-6, Groton. Middlesex would answer momentarily. Austin Dorsey to Rory Glavin. And the Tingsboro native doing the rest. Glavin's in. Touchdown plus the conversion tied the game at 14. Early in the second, this is a Sean Grady special. He loves the prep game. Beatty again. This time he scores from 5 yards out. Zebras take the lead. They get the win today, 35-27. Good win for the Groton School today. And Tim, Auburn, they hadn't won in quite a while. Mike Kelly's bunch, we saw him, got a shutout victory over Bartlett. That's a little bit of a confidence boost for the Rockets.
Yeah, exactly. You remember all those great teams that they did with the running game and a good defense. That's exactly what it was tonight. Good running game, good defense as they pitched the shutout.
Big time win for the Algonquin Tomahawks tonight over a good and rolling Holy Name team. The Teahawks are back in business. We're back with more of the Frenzy after this.
Hi, Anthony Latore, General Sales Manager here at Patera Nissan, your number one Nissan dealership in central New England.
The 2015 Nissan Rogue, lease for $199 a month. The 2015 Nissan Altima, lease for just $79 a month. And for 2016, introducing the all-new redesigned Nissan Maxima and Murano.
Deal you're looking for, I've got it. I guarantee you I'm going to give you one of the best prices around. Patera Nissan, Route 20, Auburn, Massachusetts.
It all starts with a touch. The smallest thing that sets her heart in motion. The rhythm of love, the only jewelry powered by her heartbeat.
I'm District Attorney Joe Early, and I'm proud to partner with Charter Communications with our pledge to help raise awareness that bullying should not be tolerated. From local school students, here is our message.
Delete cyberbullying. Don't write it. Don't forward it. Think twice what you type.
We need to foster safe environments for students in their schools and communities. Join the anti-bully crusade. Take a stand to lend a hand. Don't be a bully.
Presented by the law offices of Joseph J. Coriglia.
For 20 years, Enchanted Fireside's customers have appreciated our great service and high-quality hearth products. Like Enchanted Fireside, Heat & Glow gas fireplaces are a leader in their industry, and we are proud to be the only Heat & Glow Platinum dealer in the county. Visit our showroom where you'll find Heat & Glow gas fireplaces displayed in modern and traditional home settings. At Enchanted Fireside, ultimate know-how adds warmth and luster to any space in your home. Enchanted Fireside will keep you warm and happy. West Boylston Street in Worcester and at EnchantedFireside.com. We'll be right back.
There's something about central Massachusetts that makes it a great place to live and work. Our history, our heritage, our values, our resilience and drive to innovate. At Unibank, we're proud to call central Massachusetts home, and we're committed to remaining true to our founding purpose, to be the best bank for all customers, large and small. Unibank, big bank know-how, community bank attitude. Member FDIC, member DIF.
The Friday Night Football Frenzy is presented by Bay State Savings Bank, Herb Chambers Toyota of Auburn, and UMass Memorial Healthcare.
All right, welcome back. Let's jump right back into it. Monty Tech taking on Worcester Tech tonight. Down at Commerce Bank Field in Worcester, Worcester Tech's QB Luke Hanlon is going to get in for the touchdown here after a failed two-point conversion. Score 6-0, Worcester Tech. Now in the second quarter, Monty Tech answers. Steven Maxwell hands it off to Nate Maxer for the touchdown. It's an 18-yard run at that. Now, Monty Tech goes for the two-point conversion. And again, it's Maxwell in for the score, 8-6, Monty Tech. Later in the same quarter, long pass here from Worcester Tech's Nick Boyd for the first down. Next play, they take advantage. Michael Gant in for the score. Worcester Tech gonna go for two. And they get it, not enough though, as Monty Tech wins it tonight. 38-22 is your final. Oakmont taking on Littleton. Third quarter, Littleton's Anthony Rauso receives the handoff and he runs in for the touchdown. That puts him at 100 rushing yards on the season. 38-0 Littleton at this point. Two-point conversion, Eric Rauker tosses it to Griffin Shoemaker. 40-0 Littleton. Fourth quarter, Oakmont picks up some good yardage here on the run. Not nearly enough though, as Littleton goes on to win it tonight. 40-0 is your final.
All right, our game of the week is Westboro on homecoming hosting Shrewsbury. It's a little bit of a rivalry game, but for Westboro, this is a team looking to score some points. They've been shut out in recent weeks at home, and they're trying to do it against a team that's been tough to beat. Shrewsbury looking forward to a good matchup and trying to climb the ladder a little bit. Should be a good one on Saturday.
Shrewsbury is a tough team. They're very fast. They're very physical. Their quarterback's a great runner. He's really mobile in the pocket. You know, they do a lot of things that, you know, change up offensively, and then defensively, they really run to the ball. They gang tackle a lot, and they're very physical.
They have a great running game. They're very aggressive, and they never back down. So that's the thing. We can't back down with them. We have to get to them early and make sure that they don't have any momentum to build from.
They're a pretty good team. They played a lot of tough opponents, which is why their record is not showing how good of a team they are. But they match up really well with us, and so hopefully it'll be a good game.
I think we have to play a complete game, you know, and that's something that we did back in Hudson in week three, is we really played a complete game. And for us, with the way that we're trying to do things here, you know, in Rangers football, is playing all four quarters and playing all three units.
Our record doesn't show like what this team's capable of. We knew coming into the season that we had a schedule of tough opponents, but we've been working hard in practice, and we want to make our record the best it can be by the end of the year.
We just got to play our game and not make mistakes, and we just got to stop their run right up the middle. And I think if we do that and we score and keep doing what we can, we'll be all set.
They have good running backs. They have good linebackers. They're a good team overall. So every opponent is hard for us. We have to practice hard, do our thing, and make sure we get the win.
All right, Shrewsbury and Westboro. Our coverage from Mawinney Field starts at 7 on delay on Charter TV 3, channel 193. And you've got A.J. Laramie, an outstanding running back for Shrewsbury, and Anthony Caspariello on the other side for Westboro. You have two teams, Tim, that are playing week to week to win. They're only looking for one win at a time. They're not looking for anything else. And they are playing it simple and looking for this next win this week. So it should be a good one for us on Saturday.
Yeah, certainly a good matchup for tomorrow. All right, coming up next, the real reason we're here, man of the match. Stick around, we'll be right back.
So the fourth root of Z to the ninth.
St. John's is preparing me for the technology of the future.
The AP courses I'm taking now will give me a head start in college.
St. John's was a great experience for me, and I was very happy to have my sons follow me at St. John's.
St. John's prepared me for going to Cornell and Tufts Medical School, and now I'm back in Worcester practicing orthopedics with my father.
I participated in Model UN, and now I have a passion for world affairs. See the impact that St. John's is having on students today.
Who's that, Daddy?
That's the world-famous Chuckingdale.
How's your
eat
job?
Up, eat up.
Hey,
where's the new guy?
Look how skinny he is.
Eat, 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 eat.
Big food, big fun at Carl's Oxford Diner.
Yeah.
What's the rush, Coach?
It's Friday. I need to make a deposit before the bank closes.
Haven't you heard? Bay State Savings Bank has a brand new virtual branch. You can deposit that check right from your phone. You can also open accounts and complete other transactions right from your mobile device or home computer.
So now I can do my banking from anywhere.
It's banking at your convenience so you have more time to do the things you enjoy, like
watch the Friday Night Football Frenzy.
Bay State Savings Bank. We take banking personally.
Member FDIC. DIF. Equal housing lender.
Looking for a local lender you can trust? Come to Milford Federal, your family financial center since 1887. Go to milfordfederal.com to apply online. Loan serviced locally by Milford Federal.
Discover the Toyota of your dreams today at Herb Chambers Toyota of Auburn. Find the service you'd expect from a 2014 Toyota President's Award-winning dealership. We have a huge selection of new Toyotas and pre-owned vehicles for you to choose from. Shop with confidence at the Auburn Chamber of Commerce's best new and used automotive dealership. We've got the perfect Toyota waiting for you. Visit us at Herb Chambers Toyota of Auburn today, right on Route 20, or online at herbchamberstoyotaofauburn.com.
When it comes to healthcare, one phone number is all you need to remember. 855-UMASS-MD. 855-UMASS-MD connects you to our network of more than 1,600 great doctors with expertise in every specialty for adults, kids, and babies. More doctors, more expertise, more locations. Wherever you are, we are there. UMass Memorial Healthcare. 855-UMASS-MD.
Watch rivals clash as the Shrewsbury Colonials visit the Westboro Rangers. Coverage begins Saturday night at 7 on Charter TV 3.
Coverage from Central Massachusetts for Central Massachusetts.
Nikita has been a big help in keeping drugs out of the Worcester County Jail.
Worcester Public Schools are on the search for a new superintendent.
Two armed men forced their way into the home, assaulting two people.
A man in his 40s was found suffering from a gunshot wound to the head.
5-year-old Worcester boy was rushed to the hospital from his kindergarten class.
Reporters in the field. And an in-depth local forecast. Worcester News Tonight on Charter TV 3.
All right, man of the match time. My man of the match comes from West Boylston. Cole McCoubrey with 200-plus yards and two touchdowns. His offensive line paving the way for him in a big win in what must have been an emotional week over at West Boylston. McCoubrey, man of the match.
All right, this might be my only man of the match of the season, so I'm going to go off the board a little bit. I'm going to go the St. John's junior kicker, Nick Barton. I'll tell you what, to go out there with the game on the line in front of all those people and knock in a 33-yard field goal like that takes a lot. I'm going to give Nick Barton my man of the match. I'll tell you what, if that's me, I'm probably fainting. Not even making it on the field.
That's tough. You know what? You're never going to be allowed back at Wachusett. We're hearing from the control room. Let's recap. Wachusett St. John's down on the wire. St. John's wins. Nashoba knocks off Leominster tonight.
Big one.
St. Peter-Marian goes down big to Northbridge. And how about Tantasqua? Coming back off a loss to St. Peter-Marian, gets a big win over Doherty. They're the next team that has a shot maybe at Northbridge.
A lot of fun tonight. Thanks for having me.
Hey, thanks for joining us.
It was nice.
Little brother Tim McCone joining us tonight. We'll see you next time on The Frenzy.